Hi students, this is Dr. Badrinath, and today's topic is Parkinson's disease. Parkinson, S-O-N. He is a son of Parker. Actually, the father name is Parker. Son do not have name. So father asked the son, what you want to the name means. So I don't want any name since you are a Parker. Okay, call me, let all the persons to call me as a Parkinson, Parker. So Parkinson, this, so it is a one of the disease name. He only discovered the Parkinson's disease. Okay, that's why the name of this is a Parkinson's disease. Okay, like that you can remember. Okay, pharmacology. So actually, this disease is very important and very small topic. Very small topic. If you understand properly, very simple but very important. Simple and important, right? And this disease is usually comes in the old age, senior citizen. It comes so. You can call it as a senior citizen's disease also, like that you can call it as, no problem, nobody will ask you, right. So we are studying a subject of pharmacology, one theory, okay, and the highlighted point is drugs used in the Parkinson's disease, okay, very important for medical and paramedical students. And next video is Alzheimer's disease, that is, so we are moving as per the syllabus of Pharmacy Council of India, but is very important for all nursing. And here you can see the different videos of this one, Parkinson's disease, how the movement will be there. So if is there any of your grandparents are suffering like that, you may have just have a doubt on that, and you just check them. It might be a, you can suspect that it might be a Parkinson's disease. So you see here, they are unable to walk freely, small, little walk, that is number one. And hands also, see here, hands also shivering. Here also, see here, hands, first initially is not shivering. But later when he come to here, he started shivering. So here also she is shivering. And hands, you can't hold your hands like this, strictly without shaking. Definitely tremors will come. Okay. And you can't take the food properly with the spoon. See here, food is falling again into the dish. Okay. So like that, all these movements you have to keep in your mind. Parkinson's disease, right? Son of Parkin. Yeah. Changes in biological activity in the brain. Wow, what here, the important point is your brain. That is a problem. There was a problem in the brain. In the brain, where it is? Substantia nigra. Substance, see here. Substantia nigra. This is very, 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 very important. And here you can see this is a box. This box we have opened here, big. So here you can see this structure. This is called a substantia nigra. So this is a substantia nigra of non-Parkinson's disease. And this is with the Parkinson's disease. See here, there was a neurons. This is not breaking. Don't think that it was broken. No, it was. See, this is a neuron. Here, see here. These two neurons are present. That is called a dopaminergic neurons. So, dopaminergic neurons are present in the healthy person. This dopaminergic neurons are absent here. So, death of dopaminergic neurons. See here, death of dopaminergic neurons leads to the. So dopamine, also it is a neurotransmitter. Dopaminergic neuron, which conduct the dopamine, which receives the dopamine, which works, depends upon the dopamine. It's called as a dopaminergic neuron. So here, dopamine is decreased. Dopaminergic neurons decreased. Dopamine receptor also decreased. Everything dopa, decreased here. That leads to decrease in the dopa, death of the dopa, like that you can keep in your mind. That's a very, very important point. So changes in biological activity of the, in the brain, that is also in the substantia nigra, death of dopaminergic neuron. Yeah, that is the main thing. Yeah, here you can see the definition. In this disorder, dopamine level decreases in the basal ganglia nigrostriatal region of the brain, that is in the substantia nigra. Nigra, see here, nigra, substantia nigra, like that. Parkinson's disease is a long term disorder. It is because you can call it as a disorder also. Why? Means here there is an imbalance of the acetylcholine and dopamine. Dopamine is decreased. Acetylcholine is the same, but dopamine is decreased. When the dopamine is decreased, what happened? You have to maintain the balance. Here, see here. In normal person, acetylcholine is equal to dopamine. Okay, very good, excellent. In Parkinsonism, what happened? Acetylcholine is normal. but level of dopamine is decreased. See, acetylcholine is equal to decreased dopamine here. So now what you have to do, acetylcholine overactivity is also responsive here. So what happened? Acetylcholine is dominating here. So when it is dominating, it do some overaction it does acetylcholine here. Due to that only all these things will come. So here what you have to do, I will tell you what you have to do. Okay, in the next slide I will tell you. These are the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. Okay, masked facial expressions you cannot show perfectly in that Parkinson's disease. You can't show your different emojis. You can't show emojis. Okay, and stooped posture. See, somewhat bend, and here rigidity will come. Flexed elbows. Okay, flexed elbows and wrists. Okay, and tremors, reduced arm swinging. Okay, slightly flexed hips and knees. Okay, trembling. See, shaking. Here also trembling is there. Here also trembling is there. And idiopathic or primary Parkinsonism. Primary means there is no meaning. Idiopathic means there is no meaning. That's why idiopathic or primary, there was no proper reason. But however, dopamine is decreased here. Okay. Hypokinase. Movement is become less. So far, I have shown the video. Slowly walking. They're walking very slowly. Hypo means little. Kinesia means movement. Hypokinesia, rigid syndrome. Paralysis, just like a paralysis. Paralysis agitate. Okay, if you want to keep in your mind all these symptoms, trap, you can keep in your mind. Trap, tremor, shaking, usually rigidity, akinesia, okay, posture and imbalance, like that. Trap you can keep in your mind if you want all the symptoms. Okay, anti-Parkinson's medications. So anti-Parkinson's medication, it is a type of a drug which is intended to treat and relieve the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. Okay, Parkinson's disease symptoms has to be reduced. Those drugs are called as anti-Parkinson's drugs or anti-Parkinson's medication, right? Okay, anti means not neighbor anti. Okay, anti means against the Parkinson's. Okay, don't think that auntie, uncle, baba, not that auntie. Okay, here. Okay, yeah. Most of these agents act by either increasing the dopamine. Two options are there here. Either increasing the dopamine activity or reducing the acetylcholine activity. I have already told you acetylcholine is doing some overaction here. Okay, in the central nervous system. Yeah, option one and option two. What are the drugs for option one and option two? Option one boosts the dopamine. Boost it as possible. See, drugs affecting the brain dopaminergic system like a dopamine precursor. Dopamine precursor means dopamine father. Dopamine, levodopa. Levodopa means dopamine father. Precursor means father. From father only we came. In the same fashion, dopamine came from levodopa. Levodopa is father. Okay, dopamine is a son. So levodopa you can be take in the body, it is converted into dopamine. So we want to boost the dopamine. Peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor. Carbidopa. This is an enzyme. I will tell you in the next slide. I will explain you. Very clear cut mechanism of action. Very, very important. Peripheral decarboxylase is an enzyme. So, carbidopa, okay, and all these drugs will inhibit that. Dopaminergic agonist. Agonist. Agonist means which boosts, which helps. Okay, bromocriptine, ropinirol, okay, pramipexole. In the name of the class itself, mechanism of action is also there. Okay. Mechanism of action, myo inhibitor, monoamino oxidase inhibitor, selegiline, rasagiline, okay, COMT inhibitors. COMT, what is COMT, what is a MAO, what is a glutamate and all, we will see in the next slide. Deep mechanism of action of a very simple is there, one single shot for all the drugs, okay, and suppresses the ACH. As possible, you hamper, okay. Drugs affecting the brain cholinergic system, central anticholinergics drugs. This comes in that chapter, anticholinergics chapter. Same only, you can cut, copy, paste here. Antihistaminics also. Some of the antihistaminics works like an anticholinesterase also. Okay, anti-acetylcholine also. Okay, yeah. Here you can see all the things. See, keep in your mind, levodopa or dopamine you have to maintain here. Levodopa is a father of the dopamine. Okay, so in the brain, this is in the brain. First, see my pointer cursor. Don't mess up your head. Okay, periphery. This is a blood-brain barrier. Now, what happened? Generally, there was a levodopa in our brain. In Parkinson's disease, it was reduced. Okay, levodopa, levodopa. From levodopa only, dopamine will come. That we know very well. So this levodopa, what happened? It will be breakdown to dopamine. It will be breakdown into OMD. Okay, here you can see what is a OMD, methyl dopa. So it is converted. These are the enzymes. COMD is enzyme. DDC is the enzyme. These enzymes will not maintain the levodopa. So here this levodopa converted into dopamine. Levodopa is converted into. These are the drugs which kills these enzymes. Tolcapone, okay, and entacapone, okay, carbidopa, benzyrazide, all these drugs what we have shown, same only, it kills the enzymes. These are the enzymes. What these enzymes will do? It converts the levodopa into OMD, levodopa into dopamine. Here, what happened? Why we are going to stop the dopamine here? Why carbidopa? Because levodopa only enter into here. Dopamine will not enter the blood-brain barrier. That's why levodopa, if it is converted into dopamine here, it is a waste only. It is a waste. That's why here you have to avoid the conversion of levodopa in the periphery. Levodopa you have to maintain as such you have to maintain, so that you have to block these two enzymes, so that levodopa you are maintaining an excellent. This levodopa only enter. Here what happened? Levodopa is converted into dopamine. That is good. That is actually we want conversion in the brain only, not here. Because dopamine will not cross the blood-brain barrier easily. Levodopa converts. So don't stop here DDC. Don't stop. Never stop DDC here. Okay? And tolcopine. Again here conversion levodopa. Dopamine is also converted into COMT, MAO inhibitor. I have already told in the class. MAO. COMT, MyoB, MyoB, COMT, COMT, 3MT, DOPAC, HVA, okay, homovanillic acid, that is a final product, salicylline, tolcopone, all the COMT inhibitors, COMT, here COMT, tolcopone, like that you can happily you can practice this diagram, it is a good only, here mechanism of action of summary of all mechanism of actions. Dopaminergic precursors you have to use. This is the first preference. Preferred over all the other medications to prevent the undesirable sympathomimetic side effect. Peripheral dopa. Peripheral. See here. Brain is there. Peripheral is there. Peripheral DD. Dopa decarboxylase inhibitor. Prevents the peripheral degradation of the dopa by peripheral dopa. Same only. Same story. All these are the same story drawn from the diagram only. COMT inhibitor. Selective monoamino oxidase inhibitors, so dopamine receptor agonist in the writings, same only, central anticholinergic drugs, which anticholinergic name itself indicate it, this one, okay, yeah, last slide, we came to last, levodopa, it is only the main drug, it is a dopamine precursor, it is a, in the exam, don't write as a father of dopamine, in the exam, that is for your easy remembers, I am using this language, okay, general language. It is a dopamine precursor. 95% of the drug is metabolized peripherally. That is the biggest drawback, levodopa. But however, only 2% of the drug crosses the blood-brain barrier. That's enough for the treatment. It is a given in combination with the carbidopa. So, levodopa, that's why the tablets are available. Levodopa plus carbidopa. Levodopa plus carbidopa. So, what happened? Levodopa, carbidopa when given. So, you are giving this levodopa here. And again, carbidopa you are giving. That means that you are avoiding this. So, levodopa, one side you are giving and one side you are avoiding the conversion of levodopa into dopamine. So, 2% it crosses, that's more than enough. Okay, right. Levodopa and carbidopa, side effects of levodopa is also there. Postural hypotension, tests, ulcerations, okay, nausea, vomiting, abnormal movement. Actually, abnormal movement was there in the Parkinson's disease. Even though you are using, that was some another movements will become hallucinations, anxiety, dementia, rigidity, hypokinesia is also possible. Okay, right. So, we will end our session here. Keep watching all playlists. okay, total M pharmacy course, B pharmacy course, pharma D course, all the videos, all subjects will be keep on, I will keep on uploading for you only.